Today's podcast, I thought we were going to kind of continue on what we were talking about yesterday and how we were going to kind of switch some things up. And I was going to go on some add one more on our on my personal thing, kind of talk about my fiance because we were so people know when I travel, they'd kind of get an idea of who I'm meeting. And first, before we get to that, I will talk about my Patreon first. It's patreon.com/challengehistory. If you go to the thing, you'll find levels of $1 all the way $1, $10, $25, $50, and $100. At the $50 and $100, when we get up to the proper number of people, you will see that when we reach the threshold of at least a few people, the $50 we will add a yearly give initially a yearly giveaway, and it'll enhance from there. It doesn't show it on there as like when we're doing that with, but we're gonna start with a yearly giveaway, and then we'll add on from there with it, and I'll just request the user's name after that point of the patron. I'll contact them directly. Because I don't want to initially what I call it, request all your information because I want to allow you to have that for being private. And after that point, it'll be at the $50 level. It'll be a silver Roman Empire coin and the $100 level would be a gold Byzantine era coin, and those will be for those levels with the 25, 10, and the base level of $1. We'll actually have giveaways later on down the road once we get enough people for those, and I decide what to put for those. If you go on here with you, you'll actually just learn about my situation, and you'll see a little bit of an introduction I did on February 23rd. Now onto this with it, we're going to be going with this. She actually recently had a trip out to Porto Galera, which is like a nice little beach area, and it was actually for a business outing. And I think I can start with that. With it, I'll point out her when she speaks on the video, so you can kind of get an actual visual of her and see what she looks like and see what she sounds like for the actual thing. So you can kind of get a feel of her. Then I can kind of show some pictures of what she's done and what she's been up to and different things like that, and so you can kind of get a feel of who she is with it to get a more of an idea of personally who I am as well, because it kind of goes back and forth. For this, we're going to go and enlarge the video, and we're going to show it like this. If you can see her, she's the one back. She's actually back there with it. It's kind of fuzzy right now, but you'll see later. Or no, sorry. Oh, sorry. She's over. She's actually below water, I think, right now. And any foreign language you're gonna hear is actually in Tagalog. That's a language heard in Luzon in Philippines.
First time kong experience dito dahil sa Roma, nakapunta ka ng Puerto Galera na sobrang sulit at saya. Wow!
Hi, good morning. I'm Rian from Promo 300. Nandito kami ngayon sa Puerto Galera. Let's go, guys!
And here she comes up here with this one right here, the short one.
Hi guys, good morning. This is CJ from Promo 300. This is our team building and napakasaya po dito sa Puerto Galera.
Yeah, you'll see her with that, and then she's the short one with the curly hair. And if we go back, you can see that with it, and then this will actually give if we look at this picture here, you'll get it actually a little bit better of a view of her there. Let me see if I can enlarge it. Actually, no, it doesn't do much. Okay, let's see if we can go back and let's see if we can get some more pictures from the actual trip. Here's another one where she's right there in the center. That was actually the same attire that she was wearing, the lavender top with the black bottom. And she's obviously the shortest one in the whole bunch. She's not that tall with it. She's like about like 4'10". So she's noted for being kind of short with it. She's actually but she was working at a previous job. They call her Bulilit, I think it's the way it's pronounced with it, which translate roughly into like midget because of her actual height. When other people around her were at least like 5'3", she was the only one under 5 foot. If you look under here with her, you'll see a lot more for the pictures. There she is on the left. As you can see, she's the shortest one out of the three females there. She's the one in the far back. Let's see. She's the one in the center. She's a short one in the center right there. Let's see. There she is again. There she is again. She's the one in the center. Yeah, this was from the actual. It was a trip that wasn't that long ago. It was about, I think it was just over this past weekend. And she just recently posted the photos. Let's see if we can. There she's in the back there. I think we've gone, I believe we've gone through all the photos in that one. Let's see. Here's some different photos here with it. Let's see. There she is up there. It's like a cave that they're going into. Yeah, there she is again. Yeah, there she's on the right on that one. She's on the far left in that one, dead center in that one. Let's see, I don't think she's in that one. No, she's not in that picture. There, she's a short one in that picture. There, she kind of like almost hiding in that one. And dead center there. There, she's on the boat. I think that's all in that book. And here's some more here where she's where this is where they're actually going into the actual cave itself. There's where she's starting to climb down. And there's with all of them down there, and there's her dead center in in it, and there's her laying down in the actual water. There's another one with her laying down in the water. And there's her in the middle, right there. I guess that was that's most likely, I think, climbing down to it, as far as I know. I think I went through all of those ones. That should be the. And here's another one with the shots around the castle. That's her there. And if we go to. Let's get to some of our other. Albums. Yeah, here's another one with a different trip that she went on with the same group of, with roughly the same group of people. Let me see if there's any. Yeah, here's a good picture of her right there with it. That's without her glasses on. And that's up in Laguna. And that this is all out in the Philippines, just so people know. And let's continue down. This will be with her and her aunt and dog named Courage. I believe it's her aunt's dog. And it's a teacup Pomeranian. There's a Courage right there. There's her aunt on the right, there's her mom on the left, and there's Courage again. There's her with Courage. There's Courage with his boots on. There's her with Courage again. There's her with her aunt. Her with her mom and Courage. Courage again. There's her mom, Courage, and her aunt. There's Courage. There's her mom with Courage. Courage again. Her aunt and Courage. And I think we've gone through those ones. And let's see where we're at. Yeah, this was a belated birthday celebration at. It's called Vikings. It's like a buffet they have out there in Metro Manila. Yeah, here's like a little like a birthday cake they gave her for the place for the buffet, and she's there with her family, as well as I think people with the business as well, people with the business as well. Because she's there. I believe it's one of her cousins, her mom, her brother, and uh Yeah, and then one of the and then a couple of people from the business, yeah. Let's scroll down. Let's see if we can find some other good ones. Like, I can even find some like early ones as well. Like, so you can kind of see what the way she was when I first met her, which is back in like 2011. Let's see if we can find the way she looked back then. It'd be about like this with it. These are some of the first photos that she sent were like this for like a swimming party. Where that this is about like when I first met her. And like photos like this with it where she was where you can see that she looks completely different. And let's go with this, and this is from what year was this? This year, this is when I sent. This is from 2013 when I sent roses to her work. Now, it ended being as far as I remember what she said was it ended up making people around her jealous, so she didn't want me doing that again with it, but she really appreciated the roses, and there was a box that was sent with it. And if you look at what I call the box, as you can see her size with it, so you can see the box is almost as tall as she is. And you can just definitely see the smile on the face with it. It is definitely worth it. And I was as well as talking about the nickname with it right there. You can see right on the computer. This is where she was working at before. And you can see the roses right there with their full long stem roses. And there was in her room that she put it and kept where they were standing up. And basically, the box is almost as tall as she was. That should give you an idea of how short she is. Let's see if we can get. And then another thing about her with it is she's always been this idea of being a big dog lover as well. And you'll see right here with this. This is her with her dog Sue. That's at her mom's place, and she's just this is one thing that's always been one of the things I really loved about her is that she loves dogs. This is in Caloocan City, and you go over here. Here's Sue sleeping between her legs. And you'll see here's one of Sue's pups that's actually kind of grown up now, Bugger. And here's Mickey with one of with her nephew. And then here's one of their other dogs, Norton, with CJ. And CJ's short for Christine Joy. And stuff about her, she was born on December 25th of 83, for anybody interested in that. So she was actually born on Christmas, which is also, was also a little bit easy for me for remembering things, so I don't have to remember an actual date. It's just on Christmas, so if I so there's no ability for me to forget an actual gift, which is kind of cool. That's more of an actual joke than anything else with it, because I would never forget an actual gift. And if you look at some of the other things with it that, that she's done real, real nice with it, let's see. Is it under, it's not featured photos, not cover photos. Do they have mobile uploads? Maybe it's CJ's photos. Yeah, she. This is one of the things that she put for cover photos. Is she put my boyfriend is the most amazing person in the world. It'll take me forever to catch up to his level of awesome. That's one of the things she's put on her thing. Is and then what she also loves to do is I'll show you right down here. Is might take me a little bit to get to it. Okay, let's see. Let's see if we can find it. I don't know. Okay, where is it at? That has to be before then. Where was it? Okay. I don't know why it's not showing up here. Maybe these ones aren't showing up in order or something. Albums and see if this are there. Pages from his profile photos, cover photos. There, there. Maybe it's like this. Maybe if I go to this one. can't be that. Let's see if we can get to... Okay, let's... Yeah, because there's like a lot of photos on here that I'm not seeing. That's, maybe there's maybe it puts on a timeline photo or something. Okay, let's see. Let's see if we can find it. Yeah, here's what she does. Like when what she does every year with it is things like this. She'll post this like their mobile uploads. And here we go, mobile uploads. I don't know why it's not. Yeah, she does that with it, and then what she did with it for my dad's birthday was she did this. And then, if you go back with it, she also did one for my, my mom as well. I don't know when that was. Where is I need to find when October is. Let's see if we can find it. Yeah, here we go. Here's the one for my mom that she made. And this is what, this is the type of things that she does with it. I mean, you cannot ask for anybody better of a significant other. I mean, this should be exactly what you should be asking for from them. And what if you could actually get someone like this is, I mean, this is about is the best you could actually possibly wish for. And to see that they look as good as they do, that's just icing on the cake. I mean, this is another view of the one she got for me last year. And she does this constantly. She just bends over backwards to basically make sure that I'm happy. And basically, I could not come anywhere close to basically 1/10 of what she does for me. And since her mother had the same back surgery as I did, she's very, very understanding with my current situation, which is really cool. And then when it comes down to things, she's this big time thing. She's really, really interested in just having different adventures out there. I mean, if you look right here, we have her zip lining. And just doing a bunch of different amazing things. This is just what she does. And she loves spending time with her nephew. And it's just pretty much if you're gonna find and pretty much out there with it is if you look at it, she's like beyond intelligent, and but she's not stuck up or anything as well with that. I mean, she's pretty she's as low maintenance as you're gonna get. I mean, this is one of her food groups right here. She loves pizza. She loves pizza, wings, and if you see that Sprite there with it, that's pretty much when she goes out. That's what she loves Sprite, she loves, or iced tea, and then she likes, obviously, she makes sure to have, rice with every meal, like most of the people out there. And with a lot of these, you'll probably see her with Mai. That's Mai right there. With you'll see her with Mai within a lot of these photos as well. That's one of her close friends. And that's her when she went to Zark's a while back in 2016. Yes, that burger is the size of her head. And let's see, let's look at. Yeah, let's check out, I'll show you some of her, her pictures, younger in life, just as a example, just how she looked younger in life, and they'll. I'll probably wrap up the video as this, just to kind of what it called, show how cute she was as a kid as well. And I might do the Boracay, her first Boracay thing with it. That's kind of a cool trip. Like here's her thing of her own post, the way she looked with it earlier on, and kind of get an idea of the way she looked, and then you can kind of see the way she's always kind of looked. And let's see, see all. And we're going to go out to that wasn't the one that I was thinking. It was the Baho picture. I don't know why I was thinking Boracay with it. That's an area north with it. Baho is an island south with it. I don't know why I said that. But it's Baho with it. That was the area that she loves with it. Going through, she's gone there a couple times. And you have to kind of fly down there. Let's get there's her in 2014 where she flew down there. I guess they're on a boat there in 2014. And if you go at night with it, it gets like really, really loud. Because when that was a recent trip. Never mind that scratched that. But it's what it called. But I assume it might be the same type of situation. We might have a lot of the like party type of atmosphere. And here's the where they went to the here's the Tarjer Sanctuary. This is a big reason why I wanted to show people that. Might be the part of the reason why when I go out there, why specifically she wants me to go out to that island. Yeah, here's with her with a yellow Burmese python. With those the albino Burmese pythons. And there's a picture of her with a seahorse. And I will finish this off because we're at about 40 minutes now. We're gonna finish this off with pictures of the what she looked like when she grew up. Once we can find that, here we go. Here's what she looked like at 6 months old. Here's what she was like at 5 years old. Now she was at the Montessori preschool. Now, that's one thing me and her also have in common is we both had time in the Montessori school system as well. Even though we were in two different countries. Here's her at grade one at 6 years old. Here's her 11 years old. To me, she looks like one of those like Filipino beauty queens right there. Here's her at 17 years old. That's the first year of college. And then here's her. There was her right there, I believe. Yeah, there's her brother, JR, which is short for Wilfredo Jr. This is Paul. And then this is her, and then this was her father, and this is her mother. And then this is, this would be Paul. This is, this is Wilfredo Jr. or JR, and then this is her as well again. And then back to the start. So we'll just end it right there. And just cut it at the end right here. And just basically wanted to kind of give you an overview of who she is and beyond what it called, beyond me explaining that that she has that background in industrial engineering and then obviously going into different things with sales and stuff like that. And that was just basically the point with that, and then explaining a little bit about who she was with it and going over the photos, just kind of explaining kind of what she's done. What she looks like as well, and this is kind of the, just the kind of point of this little personal vlog on this. So that's about it with it. If you like it, like, subscribe, click the notification bell. Make sure to share it all the way around if you're into that kind of thing. And then make sure to check out my Patreon page, and then make sure you click the. Make sure if you can't donate, make sure that you. Share it with someone else who can. And that's about it. And bye, everyone.